Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 5, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 28, 1973, in Bombay, India.
We are discussing Tatkhetram, Khetram, this body. How we enter into different types of body, how it is obtained. There are 8,400,000 forms of body, according to the qualities. Three qualities, three multiplied by three becomes 9, 9 multiplied by 9 becomes 81. That means, in the lower grades of forms, there are 81 lakhs or 8,400,000. And above that, about 400,000 forms of human beings. So one has to understand. Unfortunately, people are so foolish at the present moment that they do not believe in the next life. Murha. What is speak of understanding God and Krishna? They have no in the basic principle of spiritual knowledge. Basic principle of spiritual knowledge is to understand that I am not this body, I am spirit soul. I am now fallen in this material condition, and therefore, according to my different desires, I am accepting different types of body and wandering throughout the whole universe. Sometimes this body, sometimes that body, sometimes in this planet, sometimes in other planet, this has become my unfortunate condition of that. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore says, Eirupe brahmanna bhamite kono bhagavan. We are wondering in this cycle of birth and death, and wondering in the universe. In this way, in the process of our wandering, somewhere or other, if we become fortunate by association of devotees, by understanding the Vedic knowledge, jnana-vairagya-sutraya, human life is meant for achieving knowledge and vairagya. Not that to increase the animal propensities even up to the point of death. That is not human life. Human life is meant for tapasya, tapodibham, putraka, jena, suddhita, satya. Rajas, Lord Ramchandra, Rajas, Maharaj Parikshit, Rajas, Maharaj Ikhaku, Rajas, there are many. They were Rajas. The monarchy was not a chief king. The king was as good as a rishi. Therefore they are called Rajas. The king used to rule over the citizens on the permission of the great sages, just like Narada. The devas used to visit Maharaj Yudhishthira, similar other things. So, spiritual science is meant for great personalities, brahmanas, kshatriyas, not for the vaishyas and the shudras. One has to get the quality of brahmana and kshatriya. So, Krishna says, therefore, imam rajarsayo vidu. And then one is rishi, great rishi, great sentry persons. One cannot understand the spiritual science. Therefore, Krishna says, although Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself, He can personally say anything which is authorized, still He is giving reference to the statement of the rishis. This is the way of Vedic understanding. You cannot establish anything dogmatically. In my opinion, it is like this. What is your nonsense? What is your opinion? Even Krishna says, Rishivi Bahuvi, Rishivi Bahuvi, Rishivi Bahuda Atita. There are different kinds of rishis. Gautam Rishi, Kanata Rishi. They are spoken in India, there are six kinds of philosophies, but they are not recognized. Rishivi, just like Devala Rishi, Narada Rishi, Vyasadeva, Asita Rishi, Valmiki Rishi, they are recognized. Rishi bhi bahuja adhutam. Therefore different philosophical ways to understand. Therefore Bhagavad summarizes that takka pratishtha sutayo vibhinya naso rishi jasya matamana vibhinya. He is not a rishi whose opinion is not different. Yes. You are a rishi, you have got some different system of philosophy. And if I want to become a rishi, then I must disagree with you, just like in modern days it is going on, scientific research, philosophical research. Therefore, it is said, naso rishi jasya matamana vibhinya. One cannot become a rishi unless he gives his personal different opinion. Therefore Krishna says, rishi means bahura adhita. Then which one we have to accept? We have to accept that is stated in the Vedic literature. Naso rishi dasya matamana vibhinya. Sutayo vibhinya. Vedic literature, sam jajuri kathadva. They are different. They are one. But we understand differently, according to our quality of understanding. Otherwise, all Vedic literature aims to understand Krishna. Vedaishta sarvai ahameva vyaktam. That is the purpose of Veda, to understand Krishna. After many, many births of studying of Vedic literature in the process of Jnana Marga, when one becomes actually wise, bhavanam janmanam ante, when he is actually wise, jnanavan, māma prabhadyate, he understands Krishna and surrenders unto Krishna. That is actually understanding. So, Chandohi vividhai pritha. But Sri Krishna Bhagavan is specially referring here is Brahma Sutra Padavishaiva. Brahma Sutra means Vedanta. Vedanta Sutra is referring. That is a proof. There are different philosophical ways. Paramarma Bhaga, Nirvishesh Bhaga, Savishesh Bhaga, Maya Bhaga, they are all rejected. Simply, Brahma Sutra Padaishchaiva, Ketuman Vi Vinishtitam. Brahma Sutra means Vedanta Sutra. It is called Brahma Sutra because the first apparition of Vedanta Sutra Tathāta Brahma Jigyāsa. This human life is meant for inquiry about Brahma, the Absolute Truth. That is human life. Therefore it is called Brahma Sutra. What is Brahma? Tathāta Brahma Jigyāsa. Janmā Adhyasya Jatavā. Brahmadashudatam. Brahma is the supreme soul, supposedly. So therefore, Brahma Sutra is called Naya-prasthan. Naya-prasthan, Sutit-prasthan, Smritis-prasthan. We have to accept this prasthan, the process of progress, to understand the absolute truth. So, Brahma Sutra is called Naya-prasthan, by logic, sufficient logic, Brahma Sutra. Krishna says that Brahma Sutra Padayas Saiva, Hekuma Guhi, Janishti, Hekuma, with reason. You must understand, Tatsadva Dhana Munayo, Jnana Vaila Gujuktaya, Pashanti, Atmanam, Atmanam, Atmane, Bhakta Sutra Gujuktaya. Vakta Sruta Gihita Tat Sadva Dhana Munayo Jnana Vairagya Jukta. One can understand the absolute truth. Absolute truth means the Bhagavan ultimately. Vadanti Tat Tattva Vidas Tattvam Jad Jnana Vagyam Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavan iti sam. That is Paratattva, absolute truth, which is known by somebody as Brahma, and somebody as Paramatma, and somebody the Supreme Personality of God. The beginners, they understand, the beginners are the neophyte realization, is impersonal Brahma, Brahma ki. Further advanced, this is the achievement of the jnani. Those who are speculative on the absolute truth, they can understand the absolute truth in the impersonal future. And those who are still further advanced, yogis, not only speculating, but they are practicing, actually. They are called yogis. Dhyanavastita-dhagdakena-munasa pasyanti yam yogino. They are yogis. Yogis, the dhyanavastita, in meditation, the mind is absorbed, always. Tadvatena-munasa. Tadvatena means Vishnu-vatena. Om Tatsat. Tadvatena-munasa, by the mind. Absorbed in Vishnu, understanding, Tadgatina-manasa, Vasyantijam-yogina, Dasyantarana-vidu-surasuragana, Devaitasmaino, Devayatasmaino-manasa. Janamambhāvarunanya-ruddhastunnanti-vibhaiṣṭavai, Vedai-śāṅga-padakku-parusatai, Gāyantijana-sāvaga. So, yogi are in the second stage of self-realization. But ultimate realization is Bhagavan. The Krishnastu Bhagavan Sayam. Bhagavan has got many expansions. Gana Singha Balaha. First expansion is Balaram, then Sankarsan, Pradyumna, Niruddha, then Narayana. In this way, Vishnu, Mahavishnu, Vadbhotaksaya Vishnu, Kirodaksaya Vishnu. In this way, the Vishnu Tattva is expanded. Advaita Akshita Anadi Ananta Rupam Adyam Purana Purusam Navajopanam. So, in this way, there are many shastras, many Vedic literature, many explanations. But here Krishna gives a special reference to the Brahma Sutra, Vedanta Sutra. Jnana Vairagya Jukta means one has to learn very nicely Vedanta Sutra. And the explanation of Vedanta Sutra, natural comment on Vedanta Sutra is Srimadu Bhagavatam. Bhashyam Brahma Sutra Nam. Bhagavad Srimad Bhagavatam is the natural commentary, because the author that day, after compiling Vedanta Sutra under the instruction of Narad Muni, his guru, Vyasadeva guru is Narad Muni. He was not satisfied even after compiling Vedanta Sutra. He was not very happy. Narad Muni advised him that you should directly describe the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then you will be happy. It is indirect. All the Vedic literatures, they are indirect, direct. Therefore, Vyasadeva took Vedanta Sutra, and from the very beginning of Vedanta Sutra, Jammadvasudataha, he commented on the Vedanta Sutra, Jammadvasudataha annayat ekadatasya akshusu avijya sarat kini brahma vidā adikavai mahyanti yatra suraya indīsya. Here, Krishna personally, the Brahma Sutra. The Brahma Sutra's commentary is Srimad Bhagavatam. Therefore, if we want to understand spiritual truth as it is, then the beginning is Krishna's instruction, this Bhagavad Gita. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita very nicely. And if you can understand Bhagavad Gita nicely, perfectly, then you try to study Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam Amalam Puranam. Amalam Puranam. Transcendental Puranam. Puranam means supplementary Vedic literature. That means complete. Because directly Vedic literature is very difficult to understand by the common man. Common man in Vedic literature is not for common man, even by the highly learned brahmanas, kshatriyas. Therefore Puranas are there, and Mahabharata is also there. Mahabharata is meant for Sri Shudra Dvijabandhunam, so you know Sri Gotara. Sri woman, Shudra, and Dvijabandhu. Dvijabandhu means born in a Brahmin family, but he is not a Brahmin. That is Dvijabandhu. Friend of a Brahmin. One is not qualified. Brahmana, sattva samadama suti khajava, jnanam vijnanam asvikam brahma tatma svabhavaya. He simply giving his identification, I am Brahmana, without any qualification as a Brahmana. He is called Vijayabandhu, friend of a Brahmana. Just like a son of a high court judge, he can say, he has got the right, that I am friend of my father, of my son of high court judge. That he can say. But you cannot say that you are high court judge. It is a qualification. Even though you are a son of a high court judge, if you have no qualification, how you can say that I am court judge? That is going on, especially in India. I have no qualification of a Brahman, but I still I say I am Brahman. But they are called Vijayabandhu. Vijayabandhu. You cannot say. Brahma Janati is Brahman. If you have got full knowledge of Brahma, then you are Brahman. Jnanam vijnanam astitam brahma karma svabhavam. And Narada Muni says that this qualification can be acquired by others also. As a son of a Brahman can by bad association disqualify himself. Similarly, a son of a non-Brahmin, he can qualify himself. It is education. It is not that it is monopoly by a certain section. No, that is not the Vedic intention. Vedic intention is, as it is in the Bhagavad Gita, Chaturbandham maya sristam guna karma vibhagasa. Guna karma. You must have the qualities अब ब्राह्मण और एक क्षत्रिय और वैश्य और शूद्र So, if you have the qualification of a Brahman, Guru, and if you act as a Brahman, then you are a Brahman. You have no qualification, you don't act as a Brahman. How you claim yourself as a Brahman? No, that is not a Brahman. This is happening in them. Narad Muni says, Yudhi Annaktrapi Vishyeta, Tatte Naiva Vinidhise. Every has got qualification. That is very natural. That is very natural. Just say that Lakaram Sad, Varnadi Madhyatam. To ascertain which class a man belongs, whether he is a Brahmana or a Kshatriya or a Vaishya, there are qualifications. Just like ordinary you will know. We understand an engineer by qualification, a medical practitioner by qualification. We don't ask whose son you are, Mr. Engineer. No. If you have got engineer's qualification, you are engineer. Otherwise, how can you be engineer? Similarly, the sahijat lakhanam sad, varna abhimanyatam. Varna. This is Brahmical quality. Bhagavad Gita is said, sattal hamadhamo tatukhajava, sojjam, tejam, vidhita, palayanam, khatriya. Khatriya must be very heroic. He'll never go away from fighting. If the Kshatriya is challenged, I want to fight with you. Yes, come on. That is Kshatriya. Similarly, Brahman, then the qualification. So, if such qualification is acquired by somebody else, even though he is not born in that family, Narada Muni says, Tatte naiva vinidhise. If a Brahmana has not acquired the Brahminical qualification, but a Kshatriya qualification, or a Vaishya qualification, or a Shudra qualification, then according to the quality, guna and what, he should be a sadhana. Similarly, others also, yadi annaktrapi vishyeta, this is happening in them. And Krishna therefore refers to Brahma Sutra Padeshaya, Hetu Madhi Vinishtita. So, we have to accept the Vedanta Sutra knowledge through Vedanta Sutra. Śrīla Diva Gosvāmī says, knowledge means Veda Gyan, Vedanta Sutra Gyan, that is knowledge. Because it is very reasonably stated. Reasonably, Hetu Madhi Vinishtita. Krishna gives the authority of Vedanta Sutra. So we should have to accept the authority of Vedanta Sutra and try to understand. But Vedanta Sutra is explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam, and if we accept Srimad Bhagavatam, first study Bhagavad Gita, and when we are but actually realization of Bhagavad Gita? Realization of Bhagavad Gita is to know Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. That is realization. Arādha Bhagavān Vrishatamaya. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Mattap Paratanam Nanya Kinchidasti Dhananya. There is no more superior authority than me. If we accept that, the Krishna is the Supreme Authority. Then you learn Bhagavad Gita. And if you try to make minus Krishna, and if you want to take the position of Krishna, like the Mayavadi, then you will never escape. There is no knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita means to accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality. And Krishna's demands, sarva dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam bhava. That is the authority. See, when one accepts Krishna as the Supreme Authority, then he can be, just like after passing your entrance examination, you can be admitted to the Devi College. Similarly, Bhagavad Gita is the ABCD of Scripture. People even cannot understand the ABC. What to speak of graduation? Srimad Bhagavatam. They have become so full, so neglected. simple thing they cannot understand. This is the position. Therefore, our Krishna consciousness movement is trying its best to make people to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is, without any nonsensical interpretation. This is our mission. But people will not take it. If you read some blog, that Krishna means you are also Krishna, I am also Krishna. Why Krishna alone shall be God? You are also God, I am also. These things will be very much appreciated. Because we bluff. But that bluffing may be very pleasing to the demons. But those who are actually students of Bhagavad Gita, they will not accept this bluff. So therefore Krishna says, manushyanam sahasresu kaschi jatati siddhai jatatamapi siddhyanam krishti vetti mahantata. To understand Krishna is difficult job, because Krishna says, manushyanam sahasresu. In thousands and thousands of people, one may be interested. But siddhi, what is that siddhi? Siddhi, perfection. The perfection is how to get out of this material class, how to stop this repetition of birth, death, old age, and that is called siddhi. So, first is other siddha. Who is interested? They are dying like cats and dogs. They are accepted. All dead is all. That's all. But there is a solution of death. But they are not interested. They are prepared to die like cats and dogs. That's all. The human life is meant for making solution of birth, death, old age and disease, but they will not take it. That's all right. Let us die. You are going to accept the next time as a tree. Never mind. They say that. I will forget. You will have to stand for 7,000 years in one place. That's all right. They have become so dull. This is called Kali Yuga. Mandasu mannamatayo mannabhagyaj bodhita. Very slow, very bad. Manna means very bad. Suvanna matayo, and if one has got some path or some sect, that is also adulterated, nuisance, manna matayo, manna bhagda, unfortunate, even people have no idea what he is going to eat tomorrow. Actually these things are coming. Manna bhagda, most unfortunate, and upadrita. I always disturbed by so many natural disturbances, health disturbances, political disturbances. This is the position. So there is great necessity of pushing on this movement, Krishna consciousness, so that their life may be perfect, although it is a difficult job. But still, we are trying our best. If people take advantage of this movement, then the whole problems of his life will be solved. That is Krishna consciousness movement. Thank you very much.